Coach O, you've had to deal with the quarterback problems, and you certainly have had to deal with them as well. What's the good news and the bad news for this ball game here tonight?
Well, probably the best news we've had in a while. Prince McJunkins, our quarterback, continues to get better. His ankle is by far as healthy as it's been since he was hurt against Fort Gibson. And we look for him to be able to do a lot more things tonight than he's been able to. We also get Paul Golden back tonight, one of our skill guys, one of our better receivers. And Taylor Bosco still out with a knee injury, the backup quarterback, starting strong safety. He'll be out for a while longer. We're not sure yet with his knee. It's just kind of a week-to-week basis. And Dalton Self, another tackle that got hurt at Poto, is a defensive tackle, still out. So we've got a couple guys back. And then we've got a couple out, but it seems like when we lose a couple, we get a couple in. So we've been able to move along just fine. You know, most importantly, getting our quarterback back to where he can run and throw both would be the most critical thing for us here late in the year. So Justin Wilson, another defensive lineman, is back. He was back last week and played really well. So those things are definitely starting to look like they're going in the right direction for us finally.
You know, when you have people go out and foray, it really affects your play, and you've got to have assistant coaches and the head coach have to get their heads together and figure out just how do we put someone else in there to take care of the person who isn't able to play. And that would be something I think the fans might like to know. What do you do in situations where you have to
They're starting for a reason. So anytime you have to go to the next guy, it's gonna weaken you a little bit. Sometimes you have to take somebody from another position so that you make sure you don't fall off too much. Sometimes you may have to take a guy that's a one-way starter and now make him a two-way starter, which, you know, at the end of the night, he's going to be a little more tired and maybe not quite as good in the fourth quarter as he had been. So those are some of the things that you deal with. But no doubt, anytime someone's hurt and that was a starter, it's going to weaken you a little bit in some places.
Coach, what have you told the kids that they have to do to win this ball game tonight? Because this is important. This is the first win of where we want to be.
Yeah, we've just told them keep doing what we're doing. And, you know, there's just a few little mistakes here and there that we're making that would make the difference in us winning and losing. You know, fourth quarter the other night, there was times we had one senior on offense on the field. So we're very young. Those guys are growing up. They're getting better. And, you know, this loss to Broken Bow was they were preseason number one, and they went through an injury problem early in the year and lost a few games, and they have them all back now and starting to play really well. So it wasn't like we, you know, went out and laid an egg against an average team. We lost to a very good football team, so we got to remember to keep our confidence up and realize we're a good team too.
You also have a great junior high team coming on strong too. I saw a couple of kids out there that really looked like they were high school football players throwing that ball almost the length of the field one day before you when you were practicing.
Well, we finish up our junior high season tonight, last night against Pryor. So all three of them doing really well, all of them with winning seasons, and the future is very bright for us.
Finally, in just about 10 seconds, what do you feel like you got to do to win tonight?
Well, again, you always want to take care of the football. I think tonight in particular, don't give up a big play to them, offensively or defensively. We don't want a turnover that they turn into a touchdown or any big running plays. So those are the things I think are most important.
Coach Conner, thank you so much for your time, and good luck to you and the Bulldogs.
Thank you very much.